Good afternoon, and welcome to Balboa Park. My name is Jerry Benson, and I have a question I'd like to ask you. Where will you spend eternity? Folks, I know this question is probably about the farthest thing from your mind, but when will you give it serious consideration? The Bible says it's appointed unto man once to die, and then the judgment. There's a day appointed for you as we speak. It's already on the calendar. The year, the month, the day, the very moment in which you will die. And folks, you cannot change it. You can't extend it and you can't cut it short. And it's rapidly racing towards you, the day of your death. And no one is guaranteed another day. And one day you'll be one of them. And you're not guaranteed another moment. And then the judgment. You must stand before the God that's created you and give an account of your life. Every thought, every word, every deed will come under judgment. And folks, most people think they'll be okay. You see, we judge ourselves by ourselves. We look around us and we say, I'm a pretty good person. I work hard. I take care of my family. I do the best that I can. And on that day, I think I'll be okay. And whatever is lacking, I'll simply petition this loving God to forgive me, and God will forgive all my sins. And I will have eternal life, and I will go to heaven and avoid hell. Folks, if that is your God, if that is your God, you'll be wrong. You'll be wrong. You see, the true and living God is holy, and He must punish sin. He must. He's promised to punish sin. And His standard, we get a glimpse of it in the Ten Commandments. We see His holiness. We see His righteousness and His majesty and how He's set apart from all creation. And God says, don't lie. And folks, we lie. God says, don't steal. And what do? We steal. God says, honor your father and your mother. And what do? We dishonor our parents, which is a sin against God. God says, don't take my name in vain. Don't misuse my name. It is holy. And folks, we blaspheme God when we take His name in vain. The name God, the name Jesus Christ, used in an unworthy manner. We're so used to it, we're not even bothered by it. We're not even troubled over it. We hear it on television. We hear it at the movies. We hear it at work. The name of God taken in an unworthy manner. And then God says, if you look with lust, Jesus Christ said, if you look at a woman with lust in your heart, He said, you commit adultery with him. You see, God looks at the heart. His standard is far beyond our own. And some of you are saying, well, yes, I've committed those sins, but at least I haven't murdered anyone. That type of person deserves hell, but not me. Jesus Christ said, if you hate your brother, if you're angry with your neighbor, you commit murder. Because God looks at the heart. And when we hate, and when we're angry with our neighbor, God says you commit murder, because murder starts in the heart with anger and hatred. And then folks, the greatest of all the commandments, Jesus Christ said the greatest of all of them, if you could obey this one command, you could have eternal life. One command, if you obeyed it perfectly, Jesus Christ said, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. To love God with all your being, more than anything else in the world, more than your own life, to love Him, and that way you would have life. Folks, who on this entire planet has done that for a single day? No one. No one. All the world stands guilty before a holy God. Guilty. 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 We stand guilty before a holy God. We deserve His wrath. We deserve judgment. We deserve hell. But folks, God has not left us in this helpless, hopeless condition. He's provided one way. One way of escape, only one. Oprah Winfrey says many ways to heaven, many ways to God. Jesus Christ said one way, I am the way, the truth, the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. You see, God in His kindness, in His grace and His mercy, sent His Son, the Lord Jesus, second person of the triune God, to humble Himself, to leave the glory of heaven. He was that glory, to submit Himself and became a man, the God-man. He humbled Himself as a servant and became a man, perfect, pure, righteous, and holy in everything He ever did or said or thought. He was suitable to become the Lamb of God, which will take away the sins of the world. You see, Jesus Christ, He hung on that cross, not because the Romans put Him there, not because the crowds cried out, crucify Him, crucify Him. The reason Jesus Christ hung on the cross is because it was the plan of Almighty God. This is the way He would save His people from their sins. He would atone for the sins of His people while on that cross. You see, it takes the shedding of blood to forgive sins, and that Jesus suffered on our behalf. He was a substitute. You know what a substitute is. One who takes the place of another. That's what He was on that cross. He was a substitute. You see, God's anger and hatred towards sin was turned to His Son, Jesus Christ. And God the Father crushed His Son on that cross. He became sin for us. He became a curse for us that we might be forgiven. The debt was paid in full on that cross. And then He rose from the dead to prove that His sacrifice was acceptable to the Father and that His people can be forgiven. So the question, how do we partake in that great gift of salvation? Does everybody go to heaven because Christ went to the cross? You see, Jesus Christ paid for the sins of His people. He has a remnant that He's chosen, that He would draw to Himself, that He would forgive. And He challenges, He tells the world to seek Him, to seek God, to humble yourself. Petition God for His mercy, and God will give you a new heart. You see, Jesus Christ told a religious man, it wasn't enough to simply believe in your head in God. It wasn't enough to simply read the Word of God and to proclaim it and to teach it. He told the religious man, Nicodemus, it's not enough. You must be born again. Nicodemus, you need a new heart. Your heart is dirty before a holy God. You look clean on the outside. Your head has got the correct thinking, but your heart is dirty. You're sinful yet in your sins. You need to believe in me and trust in me. And it's the work of God in the heart. God draws us. God changes our heart. He regenerates us. And folks, it produces repentance and faith. And I'm going to challenge you before the sun goes down today to seek God, to fall on your face and your knees before a holy God and ask Him for His mercy and His forgiveness and to give you a new heart. And then follow Him, love Him, obey Him, and delight in Him. Folks, I do appreciate your kind attention in these matters. And may God grant you repentance and faith even today. God bless you.